So this video is actually a continuation of the video I started on sizing the solar power system. From what you can clearly see here, from the heading, sizing the solar power system, I've given some analysis here where you have your 120 watts power consumption, your 480 watts power need, your 80 watt solar panel size, then your charge controller size, which will be around 20 amp, and the cost implication, which will go almost about 120k. That is for size, just sizing the small power. Look at it, I'm currently powering this TV. This TV has been on power for the past 2 to 3 hours now. We are going to 4 hours, and look at my charging system. You can clearly see my battery level 11.7. Look at the entire system. So in continuation of our analysis, we are going to break down. I was actually explaining that if I were to power a laptop, look at it from the information of the laptop charger. Which the information will be very clear for you to see. Look at the laptop charger information. If you look at this point somewhere here, it's rating 1.6 amp at 220 volt. So if we do the analysis, 1.6 amp at 220 volt, we are going to have 352, which is the total power consumption of this laptop. So 1.6 times 220, you have 352 watts. So if we divide our 480 watt inverter system, that is for the battery power, divide by 352, you will have 1.3. this 1.3 is telling us that we are going to run our laptop for about 1 hour, maybe possibly 30 minutes if we have to use the same system. So if you want to improve the scope of the system, you can increase the size of the battery and possibly the size of the panel so that you improve your charging system as well. So I will not go deep into that now. I'll possibly make a video in the future to explain how you can go with a 100 amp battery, 200 amp battery. And then if you want, if you think the cost implication is 100k, that is for this small size, just to power a 500 watt appliance for the power, just to generate 500 watts of power within 4 hours, it's too expensive. I think let's try having a point of view from the point of a generating set. Let's assume you use about 3 liters, or let's say 2 liters of petrol every day, which is almost about 200 naira now. So by implication, if you multiply it by 2, you have about 400 naira for running your generator for 4 hours. So if you do the analysis, if you multiply every blessed day, if you multiply the 400 naira times 30 days in a month, you end up having about 1200 naira. Sorry, you end up having about 12,000. Sorry, 12,000 per month just to fuel your generator. But for the case of this solar power system, if we divide our 100k, divide by 12, then divide by 30, you will notice that you if you divide it by 12, we will have about 8,000 naira per month. So 8,000 per month, you see, it's actually looking even cheaper even at this level. We didn't even put the cost of managing the generator and some other things, but still the solar power system is already cheap. That is for the first year. That is if you want to run it only for a year. Imagine if the cost implication is about 8k in the year, in a month, it means by the second year you might be enjoying the power for almost free of charge, because deep cycle battery have a period of lifespan of about 2 to 3 years. So you see, you now see that it's getting cheaper. Then if you think, even though it might appear a bit cost compared to the electricity tariff, well, let's try to measure the electricity tariff as well and see. Our 1 kilowatt of electricity power now is around 14 naira. So for 500 watts, which is about 500 watts, which our panel is generating, which our system is generating, it will be around 20 naira. So if you multiply the 20 naira by 4 hours, you have 80 naira. If you multiply it by, that is for a day, if you multiply it by 30, you will now have about 2,400 naira. So by implication, if you are to run this TV set on electricity power, we will have about 2,400 naira every month, and if it is on generator, we will have about 8,000 naira. Then if it is on generator, it's going to be about 12,000. Then for solar is 8,000, for generator is 12,000. Apart, we didn't exclude the initial cost of buying the generator and maintenance. So can you see that no matter how expensive solar looks at the initial stage, it's still worth it, and it's even more efficient. There is no noise, especially for somebody like me that don't like the noise of generator. So let's enjoy the jams as we move further to other things.